We're going to start with those host of profit reports. They keep on rolling in until the end of this week. Ed Boyd with me for the market reaction. And I can tell you, Ed, that there have been some big moves in both directions today. We're going to start with Coles, which, like its rival Woolworths, is in the midst of government inquiries and accusations of price gouging. Coles half-year sales gained just 3% on a year ago. Inflation last year, remember, was 4.1%, so it's less than that. Coles profit fell 8.4%, $589 million. The dividend is flat, 36 cents a share. But the paranoia of the supermarkets right now saw Coles only speak one-on-one with reporters from print media outlets, so the Fin Review, The Australian. No electronic media, nothing for you or me. In other words, the Four Corners episode has them spooked, there's no doubt. The supermarkets, if they were effective communicators, which they're not clearly, have a decent argument to mount. For starters, the return on the shareholders' capital at Coles is 16.4% in this half. Give you a comparison. JB Hi-Fi last year, it was 47%. Wesfarmers showed Kmart's return on capital this half, 58.8%. So where's the inquiry into the discount goods in Australia or into electronic gear here? The supermarket inquiry, which has put the retailers in an absolute flap, is politically convenient to divert attention away from the government's management of inflation and its cost of living. Who better to blame than the big retailers where people shop the most? Here's Coles boss, Leah Wickart today, Wecker today, doing her best to explain it in a press briefing.
In terms of our profit, we make around $2.60 for every $100 a customer spends, so less than 3 cents on the dollar. And that margin has now been stable for at least the last 5 years, and it has not gone up as we have seen inflation come through.
Now, Ed, for everything that's being said at the moment, this profit was better than expected.
It was better than expected, Ross. So there was a positive share market reaction too. The share price popped today. Coles shares jumped 6% at the open, finished the day a little bit lower than that at about 5.5%. Just as a comparison, you can see Woolworths on the screen there. That was up slightly compared to Coles, Ross.
Thanks so much. Well, next is the oil and gas giant Woodside. The fall in energy prices over the past year, plus write-offs in WA and in the US, well, it clobbered its profit, as you can see here. Despite record production, operating revenue fell 17%, net profit fell 37%, $3.3 billion. The final dividend was cut by 84 cents a share to 60 US cents. Now, I spoke earlier with Woodside Chief Executive Meg O'Neill about the fall in revenue and the drop in cash flow of more than 90%.
The crystal ball game is a difficult one to predict. I would suggest that 2023 is more representative of the long term. But the reality is we've got geopolitical question marks continuing. You know, we've got war in the Middle East. Thus far, that hasn't particularly affected trade flows, but it's something we watch closely. We've got an election in the U.S. The U.S. economy is still a very significant contributor. The Chinese economy is significant. So we'll be watching those three factors to see what that means for energy demand and energy pricing.
And that full interview with Meg O'Neill will be on Business Weekend this Sunday, 11 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. Let's see how the market took all of that. Ed, Woodside shares?
Investors were pretty forgiving to Woodside. It's clear the profit is obviously underpinned by commodity prices. So when prices drop, the profit falls. Today, the company's shares held up pretty well. They were up basically 1%, Ross.
All right, I'm going to go to one of the stock market's unheralded darlings in the past 4 years. This is the plumbing supplies company called Reece. Broadly, the market had been expecting Reece's profits to fall this time around, but it didn't happen, as you can see. Its chief executive, Peter Wilson, forecasts subdued demand across the whole business in the second half, with a softening environment in Australia and New Zealand. But Reece shares are up about 70% in the past year, 250% in the past 4 years. What did they do today?
They kept rising today, Ross. It was the best performer on the market. It jumped sharply in early trade. Investors clearly impressed with the results, despite management flagging a softening in the Australian market during the second half of this financial year. You can see Reece was up about 18.3%, and that's basically at a fresh record high.
All right, we're going to go to another company. Share price goes all over the place. This is the credit provider Zip. Now, for the company, there's good news. It's made its first profit ever. Its first half-yearly profit, this is after 11 years, came after a big jump in transaction volumes, up almost 10% to $5 billion. That's most notably in the US. You can see that they've made a profit of $57 million. Ed, look, this is notoriously volatile, but the shares have at least off a very low base tripled since about last October. What about today?
Today, not so much. Look, you go through Zip's results and there's various different ways that they've put their half-yearly report figures. Investors might have latched onto its adjusted loss before tax, which was negative $1 million. So you can see shares today for Zip down about 14.5%. Turning to the overall market, ASX 200 opened lower this morning, pushed down by property REITs and healthcare stocks. Consumer staples was the best sector, thanks to Coles. The market did recover, though, in the afternoon, finished up by 0.13%. Australia's largest listed childcare provider, G8 Education, well, it raised its fees 4.5% during the year, which helped it report a net profit of $56 million. Tech stock Appen lifted after reporting a loss of about $53 million, down from a loss of $240 million the prior year. And industrials company CSR lifted again after the board accepted the $4.3 billion takeover offer from French company Saint-Gobain. Private hospital operator Healius, it dropped after its half-yearly report showed its COVID-related revenue had plunged. Data networking company Megaport slumped, and Alumina fell after reporting a loss of $150 million US dollars in the full year. And remember, the Alcoa takeover is ongoing. And Ross, that's market.